What do your parents think about you guys being in a punk rock band? Are they for it?
My parents are super stoked. They're really supportive. I think because we're like older, do you know what I mean?
Yeah. And successful.
Yeah, it's going good. So I think our families are really behind us in the fact that they know that, you know what I mean, this is what we want to do with our lives and what we're actually doing. And it helps that we get to do cool things, you know.
And I think they recognize that we're working hard at it. You know, we're not just, you know, sitting around, you know, at home doing nothing. We're actually out on the road, you know what I mean? Like 10 months a year at least. And it's like, you know, they can see that we're really working towards something. And then, you know, when they're able to see us on television or whatever, or hear us on the radio, that kind of thing, you know what I mean? I think, you know, I can see my parents, you know, getting really proud. It makes me feel good too, you know?
But what about in the beginning? Like, were they like, can't you just be like, you know, an electrician?
But I think any parent's going to do that because they want their kid to have security and have, you know, a well-off future, that kind of thing. I mean, and I think that's important. That's cool. You know what I mean? That's just showing that they love you, you know, but everybody is going to find their own way through.
But
at the end of the day,
even from the beginning, I guess, like, because again, we were older when we were starting this. It wasn't like we started this band when we were 16. Like I was, you know what I mean? Like 25. When we decided to do this band, like, for real. Like, Scott and I had started it up, and it was just like, okay, we're actually gonna do this, and we're actually gonna tour, and I'm not gonna work a real job. And my parents were just like, okay, cool. Like, we know this is something that you wanted to do, so we'll support you in it.
Yeah, that's the hardest thing, is, you know, actually quitting everything else in your life to just go straight.
What were you guys doing before?
Working jobs, doing whatever. I was actually living in Montreal, working for, like, a telemarketing company. Before we did this, and then when the band started like really kicking it off, I like, you know, quit my job, moved to Toronto, so didn't have a job or a place to live or anything. I was staying with friends, living with our old bass player actually in his kitchen, and that was when we were like starting the band, like, okay, we're gonna do this full time, we're gonna actually like tour. And that also got us a lot of like attention from people, just like within the music industry, to say that like, you okay, yeah, we're gonna be serious, and we have this, you know what I mean, demo right now, we want to tour. We're willing to do anything, and people being stoked.
Speaking of anything, though, like I heard you guys were, to promote your band, you would graffiti bats.
Yeah, we did a lot of wheat pasting around town, more just because we had a lot of, like, you know, excitement about the band.
And that was, like, right at the very beginning of the band. Like, you know, we barely even put out our demo at that point. It was just kind of, you know, something fun to do. We like art, and, you know, graffiti's one of the
things.
Yeah,
you guys are big
into
graffiti fans, right? Like, all city?
I'm definitely a huge graffiti fan. And, like, just getting really, I was really into that scene when I was living in Montreal and that whole, like, art community. So wheat pasting was, you know, really rad way to do it if you weren't good at, like, spray cans and stuff like that. So I got really into, like, doing a lot of that. Sadly, since the band's, like, taken off, I haven't had a lot of time to go out wheat pasting at the end of the day, but.
But the cool thing is that some of our fans have since kind of gotten into that scene through, you know, like our video, 100 Grand Canyon, where it's all kids, like, you know, bombing walls and stuff. And, you know, like some of our fans will come and show us, like, hey, you know, I've put up these, you know, really cool wheat paste all around the city, and this is what I'm really into. And I think that's cool, just, you know, that, you know, us as musicians, that's our main focus in terms of art. But you know, raising awareness of other kinds of art too, I think is just really cool.
And you're into graphic design too, you were saying?
Yeah, more so our old bass player, Andrew, was like, runs a graphic design company called Double Knot, which does all of our layouts, website, our
merch.
Yeah, everything. And so that was more of when he was in the band, that was like, you know, his real focus. But then his company got to a point where he had to choose between the two. So he now just does graphic design, and we have a new bass player.
But it's cool. He's sort of like this unofficial fifth member, because he helps us out a ton, and his input is, you know, just as considered as any of the other guys in the band, which is cool. He's like our best friend, so it just
and
works.
And he still, like, has, like, like that art direction and is still in control. Like we're currently like we're gonna press Hail Destroyer on vinyl, and Andrew's been taking you know a hold of that, and the guys at the company were just like you know sending emails back and forth, and they're like, what do you think? And I'm like, I don't even care. Like this is all up to him. You know what I mean? Whatever he does, we definitely back. So you don't really need my opinion. Like, whatever he says goes.